When I get everything set up and I'm ready to cut threads, I get the tool into the piece, touch off, hit that button to go forward, everything moves. Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video. This is my Harbor Freight 3-in-1 mill lathe combo. It's been a great machine and I've loved using it to make all kinds of parts and pieces. The problem is, it was never set up from the factory to cut threads. I looked into several options, thought about buying change gears and trying to figure out how to make those work, but I could never really come up with a simple solution to add thread cutting capability to this machine. So, I was about to pull the trigger on a newer machine that had change gears set up, but then, when I was taking classes at YSM, heard Blondie Hacks speak of an electronic lead screw put together by a gentleman named Clough42. It eliminates all the change gears and uses electronics to synchronize the spindle and the lead screw to be able to cut threads. Upon further research, I realized the Clough42 setup would be a fantastic option for me, and I went to getting all the parts and pieces I needed to add an electronic lead screw to my machine. I want to give special thanks to Clough42. I ran into a couple bumps in the road and I sent him an email. He was extremely helpful, always answering my questions. Fantastic guy. If you haven't seen his channel or Blondie Hack's channel, I recommend that you check them both out. This is where the system starts. The electronics have to know what the spindle is doing. So you install an encoder, that piece right there, that's driven off of the spindle. This is a 40 tooth timing pulley that was slipped over the snout of the spindle. It started life, just like this one, with a 25 millimeter opening, and I had to stick it in the lathe and open it up to 40 millimeters to get it to fit over the snout. I still have full access to run long stock through the spindle. The signal from the encoder comes down into this box. All of my electronics are inside this, and various wires and connections come out of it to run the rest of the system. Here we have the stepper motor, also using timing pulleys and belts, going up and driving the lead screw. This is my lead screw to stepper motor clutch mechanism. It allows me to engage and disengage the lead screw from the stepper motor. Works very simply, just with a lever. There is further information on this mechanism with a breakdown of how exactly it works and all the parts involved on another video I have in my YouTube channel. I have two separate control panels for this unit. This is the Clough42 control panel that allows me to thread and do auto feed based on how fast the spindle is moving. But I also added this, which is a basic stepper motor controller that independently of the Clough42 system allows me to use the stepper motor as a power feed on my X-axis. I'm planning on mounting it in a box and cleaning these wires up, but for now, it's just the loose circuit board. I'm also going to mount the Clough42 control panel, but I haven't figured out the best place for it yet, also being concerned about it seeing a lot of chips and oil and that kind of thing. Almost as important on this project is the controls to my lathe. I have these knobs which allow me to adjust the speed of the spindle. I've got this button which gives me forward on the spindle, off in the middle, and reverse. This is extremely important as it's how I control what everything is doing when I'm threading. Main control box has all the electronics. Got a fan. It's a little big for this application, but it works pretty well. You have the stepper motor power supply. The power supplies that are powering this board and the other control panel for forward and reverse feed. You've got the stepper motor controller. You've got the main brains of the operation, the
board and then the Clough 42 board. I've got several connections. This is where the encoder comes in. This is where it goes to my power feed control. This switch right here gives me, this is for threading when it's down. When it's up, it's going with the power feed. And then this is the master power switch that powers up the entire system.
So let's start with the power feed. Power comes on. It's got two buttons. You've got the main power button, and then you've got the directional button, and then you've got speed control. So when you turn it on, as you see, it moves. It's clipping right along, and it's actually going the wrong direction. Easily turn it off, switch directions. I can also switch directions while it's moving. I have some half inch stock in the lathe and I'm going to cut some half inch 13 threads. So to do it, what we do is we put it in thread mode. And then we change the threads per inch down to 13. To actually cut threads, I start by coming in and turning my direction control to the off position. I then turn the power on the lathe. Then, assuming my speeds and feeds are all correct, and I have the blade just barely touching the tool for a scratch pass, I hit forward. Once it's gone as far as it needs to and I'm into the runout gutter, I turn it back off. I wind the crossfeed back out so the blade is no longer touching and run it back the other direction past the material I'm working on. Then I turn it off again. From there, I can slide it back in, taking another, say, 5/1000ths cut, and go in again with it in the forward direction. I rinse and repeat until I have the threads cut perfectly so that a nut screws on.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.